Hi, I'm here for your heat. You should be expecting me, correct?
Okay, come on in.
Thank you. I'm Mike, and Derek is behind me to learn.
Good luck, Derek.
Please lead the way. So right now you have no heat, correct?
No, I have heat now. It kicked on.
So now it's working?
Now it's working. It, one day it goes, once on and off, it's...
Okay, did you let him know that it turned back on?
I did. He said he's going to send you anyway because he doesn't want to keep getting these phone calls.
It's okay, so on. Now that it's working now, let me just interrupt you for a minute. Sorry.
No problem.
When did this problem start with...
A couple of weeks ago.
And what happened? No hot water, no heat?
No hot, no, exactly. He came here, he took a look, he said there's a sensor there, a little screen, it says a lockout.
Okay.
And he...
Reset it,
and it seemed to work for a week or two.
Then what happened?
Then I saw again.
And then what happened? He came back?
He came back.
Okay.
He knocked a little on a little pipe valve there, he says...
You know what he knocked on?
Oh, yes.
Okay, let's go see.
It may be low water.
Oh, let's see.
Reasons. Okay, here's your patient.
Old Burnham.
Yep.
And they have the relay there.
That little green thing up there, you asked what he knocked on, like
this?
Yes.
He tapped on that.
Yes, and he said some water, you know, then he heard a little something. He clicked.
Interesting.
Not sure if water was being blocked somewhere.
All right, let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
How long have you lived in the house for?
Just 41 years.
Okay, a while. How long ago did they put this box in?
I have no clue. I don't know if it...
That is not original with the boiler.
It is not.
No.
Okay, so I...
And someone decided to take out what was there and give you that. And again, you took something mechanical that was there before, and now they made an electromechanical, which I like to keep it simple.
Yeah.
So when you start complicating things, listen, if it's a high efficiency boiler that doesn't use a chimney, it vents out with PVC pipe, I get it, you know, what have you. But when you have a cast iron boiler, 80 cents is heating your home of every dollar, 20 is going up the chimney, standard efficiency, you don't want to complicate things with a control like that. So... If the lockout error is there, and you're not overshooting in temperature, like overheating, and you have water pressure where it should be, then it's probably a control or a sensor with the control that's failing, and it's probably best to go back to the way it was. But let me take a look at everything, and we'll see what's going on. But this is an older boiler. It's probably from the early 80s. The service sticker dates from 96. And 245,000 BTU. It's a big boiler. And I mean, it's probably from the 80s, if I can guess correctly. But
yeah, that's when we came here.
And right now we have, it's in standby status. The temperature is 165 degrees. And this is going to be one of those annoying things.
And it was lockout. I reset it. I hit the reset button. I shut off the switch. It did not go back on. It continued to say lockout.
All right, we have this Beckett AquaSmart aquastat, and it's no bueno. We keep getting errors and lockouts because of temperature sensor. And does this thing come off easily? Yeah, it does, actually. Look at that. Now, I can almost bet anything that before this was installed, a traditional mechanical aquastat relay was here. This is that temperature probe. Right, it goes in there like that. Right, it's no bueno. So, we're going to make things simple again. Now, let's just take a quick peek on what we have here. So, we have these two wires here. That looks like it's B1 and B2. That's our burner circuit. So, let's get a Phillips screwdriver. We're going to undo the burner circuit. This is going to our gas valve. Let's remove C1 and C2. This wire goes to that circulator, that TACO 007, to that line, which is going to our indirect. Right? Our indirect is always maintaining temperature, right? So So since that's always maintaining temperature, it's basically keeping the boiler on 24/7 at temperature as well, right? So this is our indirect circulator. And then the wire here, TT, right, is normally would be thermostat, but that's our indirect. And we're gonna clean this up because this looks like an amateur put it in. Here's L1, L2, and that's that. And let's just take this little ring off. Come on. Why are you being so stubborn? It's hitting that little wire nut back there. See the stupid thing right there?
Yeah.
Get out of here. So annoying. Okay. So now everything is disconnected off this control. 5/16 driver. 5/16 driver. Pull the whole tool bag here. 5/16 driver. Yes.
Oh, like the screwdriver?
That's what it's called, the 5/16 driver, right? I'm gonna take this off the well. Not yet. There it is. The AquaSmart by Beckett. The complicated thing. Here's the replacement AquaStat radio we're gonna use. Honeywell 8148. We have a burner circuit for 24 volts, control circuit 24 volts, circulator circuit 120 volts. I have a range of 180 to 240. And it's got the, it says it has the conductive compound less the well, vertical mounting. So here is the AquaStat relay. You know 100% this is what was in here before. Now, very important. See this stuff? Mm-hmm. This stuff is nasty. This stuff is the same as this stuff. Right here. Mm-hmm. Heat conductive compound. You apply this to the probe, and essentially you need to lick it before you stick it. Okay? This is going to go into that well. It's pretty deep, and this will lock into place with that 5/16 thing, just like that one.
Yeah, yeah.
Cool? All right, let's take a look at our terminals. Okay? This just says zone. We have our burner circuit, B1, B2, circulator for C1, C2, L1, L2. What this is missing is that ZR terminal that's going to that relay over there. We'll figure that out in a little bit. You ready? Mm-hmm. We will. But when I tighten this up, I'm bringing this, these little teeth to grab onto that, similar to the way that was. So keep that in mind. So we're going to take this. We're going to carefully put a little hole in, a little tear in this. Okay. And now we will put our probe inside the compound. Get in there. It's making a fool out of me. Okay, all up on there. Yeah, I got her good, didn't I? Okay, now, you don't want to get this stuff everywhere, so you want to pay very close attention. It's like the game of Operation. We want to get that into the hole. See? You heard that little pop, didn't you? Yeah. Okay, now. Make my life a little bit easier. I'm going to turn off to the side a little bit. And we're going to take that 5/16 driver. And we're going to tighten this up. And once it's tightened up, we will put it in the vertical orientation. And this is going to be nice and tight. Good and tight. She ain't going nowhere. All right. There she is. Thermostat goes to T and TV. Thermostat is actually our aquastat, which is set for 180 degrees. So the base of the boiler is a 24/7, 365 maintained temperature at 180 degrees. So the way this works, Derek, we have 110 volts going into L1, L2, all right, the bottom right-hand corner. So this always gets power. There's a transformer here, which powers the low voltage control side of the system. So we have an aquastat or a thermostat, which senses water temperature, which is that probe which is inside the well. So, and that's set for the lowest temperature, which is 180. Now, when the water heater, which is set for 180 degrees, mm-hmm. needs to be satisfied, the T and TV circuit closes, right? And then the transformer sends 24 volts to the burner circuit, B1, B2, which is here. Mm-hmm. And on the burner circuit, we just have a gas control valve. There is no other safety mechanism on this boiler other than high temperature limit. It's an old boiler. Look at it. This is a 245,000 BTU boiler. There's a serial number, 17061880, model P210W. There's no rollout switch. There's no spill switch. There's no automatic vent damper. We could theoretically increase some efficiency to this boiler by wiring the automatic vent damper to that plug there. But no. If you wanted to, we could, on the 24-volt circuit, B1, B2, wire in a rollout switch, which this does not have, right? And put in a spill switch, which it does not have. But the boiler's age predates those kind of safety mechanisms on the system. So the only safety here is the high limit. When the boiler reaches that temperature, you're good. Mm-hmm. And the zones, multiple of them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, minus one, which is the indirect, all are on that five zone control. And this appears to be for these two zone valves. With a thermostatic mixing valve there, this probably is radiant of some sort. But there you have it. It's an ancient boiler that's older than me and you combined, and is still purring like a kitten.